It's time to go racing once again then here at Zandvoort as we get underway at the Dutch Grand Prix. Zandvoort circuit then, 14 corners, 10 to the right and 4 to the left, with plenty of steep camber and elevation changes to keep our drivers on their toes throughout the 2.6 mile lap. And watch out for cars making use of the DRS zone into turn 1 to attempt an overtake. So with the race not far away from starting, here's what today's grid rundown looks like. A fantastic effort from Charles Leclerc yesterday, and it's put him on pole. And starting next to them is George Russell. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Sainz, Verstappen, and Sir Lewis Hamilton, and Perez, Joe, Mick Schumacher, Fernando Alonso, and Esteban Ocon, Norris, Gasly, Kevin Magnussen, and Ricciardo, Tsunoda, Bottas, Lance Stroll, and Sebastian Vettel, Albon, and Nicholas Latifi. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track. And a warm welcome, of course, to my co-commentator here today. It's Natalie Pinkham. Can we begin by having a chat about Charles Leclerc?
Well, it was a really impressive lap in qualifying to get pole position. But are they going to be able to hold on to the lead into the first corner with so many quick starters around them? And let's see who's able to keep their tyres in that temperature sweet spot early on. You've got a great tyre warmer underneath your right foot, and the drivers need to make the most of that on the formation lap, or they'll skate wide at turn 1 on cold rubber.
The formation lap gets underway and every driver will be looking to settle in for the race ahead, making sure that their car is ready for the battle once the lights go out. Take their positions on the grid, the teams will be hoping their strategies pay off for them in today's race. The question I'm asking is which teams have got it right, which ones have got it horribly wrong. Thank you.
enabled. At the moment, no rain currently expected. Okay, dry seem like the best tyre for now. Job, nice overtake. Approaching the pit window and you're going to be on mediums. Okay, be careful, we think you're going to start losing some tyre grip anytime now. narrowing our gap on the car behind by around a second a lap. We're coming in this lap. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. Look after these tyres now, we want to finish the race on this compound. Sergio is in for his stop. Yes, great job, great job. Excellent work. That's first place now, P1. behind's just boxed for mediums. Car behind on the medium tyre now. To your teammate behind is 3.1 seconds. Currently, the fastest lap is a 1:17.7. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 3.5 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. They're in third. Time last lap was a 1 minute 19.6. Lost a position, that's us down a place. And that's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. Race. Race over. Take care of the car on the way in.
Well, what a drive that was to take the win for Ferrari today. So, Natalie, what do you think helped them deliver this result?
I really feel the track layout combined with the track temperatures we saw today suited their car. These cars come alive when the tyres are just at the right temperature, and the driver did a great job managing that as well. They just look so comfortable out there. It's like anything, it always looks so easy when it all just clicks.
Ferrari are at it again. An excellent performance at today's Grand Prix, and they're certainly a team that know what they're doing out there.